So I've always used this large table saw sled for sizing up lumber and making cross cuts. And with a long steel guide bar, it's really sturdy so I can easily cut the end off of a large 8-foot piece of lumber. But for small stock, it's not ideal. So I built myself a small table saw sled, and this one doesn't have to be very large because I already have the other sled. And this sled has turned out to be really, really handy, and I've used it an awful lot. And sometimes people ask me about how to build one of these. So I've got some ideas for how to improve on this one, so I'll build another one and make a video of it just to show you how. For the runner that's going to run in the T-slot, I'm going to use some exotic hardwood. This, I think, is Cocobolo. I picked that out of a dumpster from some hardwood flooring store. So I'm going to rip that to just a bit wider than I need it to be. So the T-slot in my saw measures 756 thou. There's 805. My piece is about 50 thou wider than the slot. So I'm going to take the fence and move that by exactly 50 thou. So using the dial indicator, it's actually not that hard to get one of these things on the thou just by bumping it. So far this doesn't fit in, not unless I drove it in with a hammer. And measuring this, I get 760 thou, whereas shooting for about 755. But what happened is, as I was only grazing the side of the saw blade, the blade got deflected this way a little bit. But now if I make another cut and move the fence by about 6 thou, I should be able to get it bang on. Let's check that fit. And that appears to be a very exact fit. So on my previous small table saw sled, I just screwed the guide rail to the bottom. But on this one, I made it a little bit thicker so it sticks out above the table. And I put a dado, this is just a test piece, into the plywood. So that's going to attach on here, make the rail a bit thicker and give it better attachment. And I cut that dado just with a series of table saw cuts using a saw blade that has got flat teeth. This is a 9-inch Freud saw blade with flat top teeth. I want to start that dado at about the same distance that I've got from the edge of the blade to here, so that's 11 centimeters. So I need to move my fence to be 11 centimeters from the blade, and this is just a few millimeters more. That's good, that gives me a little bit of safety margin. I need to widen that slot by just a smidgen. So here's my dado, it looks very nice. And this fits in. I've got, unfortunately, a few thou of play. So I'm going to try some hot glue to take up that play. I don't really want to glue this in permanently, but I just want to get rid of the play. So I'm preheating the woods and the rail here so that when I put the hot glue on there, it'll flow nicely so I don't get this thick bead in there. I'm just putting a tiny bit of glue in there, just enough to fill a few thou worth of gap. And gotta work quickly. Okay, that's stuck in there good. I'm using some half-inch number 4 screws to now lock this bar in place. And I've pre-drilled them to be just a tiny bit smaller than the outer diameter of the screw, because in this exotic hardwood, these screws really hold.
Next, I need to make the front and back rails, and I'm starting with a big piece of 2x10, and I'm cutting end off of that using my other table saw sled. And once more over the jointer to remove any slate from the thickness planer. Now I'm far from done with making this sled, but the next step here is to cut the slot in it. Next I need to mount the fence part on here, and that needs to be exactly perpendicular to the line of cut. Now having cut my slot already, I can just use a square, put that flush with this here, just using another piece of wood, and that lines up for where to put this here. Now the square I'm using is just a framing square. In my experience, these are very reliable squares. I've never had a framing square that was out of square, so I always trust these for my reference. What I neglected to do before I screwed this together is to put a chamfer on the inside edge here. That way there's a place for some of the sawdust to get caught. And I'm just going to screw this back together, and the location of my screw holes, because they're all very tight, is going to help line things up again. So hopefully I'll have it all precise, but I'll give it a check. Now I'm ready to mount the rest of the floor of this jig. And how I mount that is actually not that important. Now to keep my hands from possibly touching the blade when it comes out of the sled right here, I'm just going to glue a little block of wood on here. Now here's a new safety feature, which I'm not entirely sure if it's a good idea. We'll see how it works out. This little block is going to flip on here, and it prevents the sled from moving too far back. The idea is this block is normally up, but when I push the sled back, it'll catch on my outfeed extension, and so I can't push it far enough that the blade comes really far out. So unless I'm making a really deep cut, when I push this as far as it'll go, the blade doesn't really come out here. It's coming out here just in the corner here, but I'd really have to reach hard down here to even catch that with my fingers. So it should be an adequate safety thing. I didn't want to make the sled too bulky on here. I put 3 coats of varnish on the sled, but only 1 coat on the inside, so it doesn't get too slippery there. So here's my sled, all finished.